now on Coast TV News.
New tonight, Delaware's booming population proven statistically how many people are moving to the first state. DelDOT will begin a study that could result in passenger rail service in Sussex County, what it means for your travels. Secretary of State Antony Blinken arriving in Mexico, what's at stake for today's meeting between the U.S. and the Mexican president regarding the border crisis.
And find out how Delmarva's light showers will affect the rest of your work week.
This is Coast TV News at 5.
Data shows Delaware is growing at a fast rate. Good evening. I'm Madeline Overturf. Charlie Sakaitis has the evening off. Welcome to our news at 5. We begin tonight with Delaware's growth more than you may have thought. If you've been thinking the population of Delaware is growing, you're definitely correct. The U.S. Census Bureau says that Delaware is the sixth fastest growing state in the country by percentage. Coast TV News reporter Alisa Weber is in the newsroom. Alisa, people in the area say they believe it. They weren't shocked. It's not higher, actually, because of how crowded the first state is becoming.
Maddie, people say from increased traffic to more homes being built, it is obvious that Delaware is growing. According to the U.S. Census, the total population of Delaware has grown by 1.2% over the past year. Now, the U.S. Census believes the growth is the result of the country coming out of the pandemic, causing people to move. One business worker who moved to Delaware almost 40 years ago says the state has changed a lot over the years.
I started coming here in 87 when there was just a lot of farmland, and now I can find anything I want to eat and I can shop just about anywhere, and I love it.
Another item to note is that Delaware's population is now over a million, and just 3 years ago it was under that. And South Carolina was the fastest growing state at 1.2%. Back to you.
Now, with Delaware listed as number 6, where did Maryland and Virginia fall? Well, Virginia was listed as number 8 on the list of top 10 of states by numeric growth from 2022 to 2023. As of July 2023, the state's population grew by over 36,000, taking the overall population to over 8.7 million people. According to the Census Bureau, Maryland didn't make either of those top 10 lists. But, however, it's worth noting the state is now gaining a population after a fall in 2022. The state saw a growth of just over 16,000 people in Maryland this year. The possibility of a passenger rail service like Amtrak coming to Sussex County is gaining momentum. The Delaware Department of Transportation will begin a study early next year to assess population density and demand for a railway. The line could facilitate travel from the top of the state down to the coast, the eastern shore of Maryland specifically. According to DelDOT, this study comes as a solution to heavily trafficked roads, saying the population growth in Sussex County has gone up 20% in the last decade. People in Lewis are looking forward to a transportation alternative.
Especially as we're getting older, and we ourselves don't like to drive as much. So I can see myself, as I'm getting older, going up to Pennsylvania to visit the kids.
DelDOT says it hopes to have the results of this train study by mid-2025. And that brings us to our Coast TV poll. We want to know if you would use restored passenger rail service in southern Delaware. Let's take a look at the results. So far, a majority say yes, absolutely. 15% say no, and 7% say only if it's on the coast. And because the exact location hasn't been determined, it could be farther north, such as Dover or Harrington. That's been discussed. Well, if you haven't voted yet, you can do that at CoastTVNews.com or our mobile app. Next week, the Maryland Department of Transportation's State Highway Administration is continuing long-term repairs to the U.S. 50 bridge. Beginning on Wednesday, January 3rd, crews will work 24 hours a day. And while this work is happening, the two eastbound lanes and the eastbound sidewalk of the bridge will be closed to create a safe work zone. Two-way traffic will be maintained using the westbound lanes of the bridge. Work is expected to be done by March 2nd. As a reported 8,000-person caravan of South and Central American migrants make their way towards the U.S.-Mexico border, Biden administration officials are in Mexico City today meeting with the country's president. NBC's Alice Barr reports on how Secretary of State Antony Blinken and Homeland Security Secretary Alejandro Mayorkas are leading a U.S. delegation for the negotiation as they work towards addressing the, quote, unprecedented irregular migration in the Western Hemisphere, end quote, according to the U.S. State Department.
Today, a clear illustration of the swelling numbers of migrants at the U.S. southern border. An estimated 8,000 men, women, and children slowly moving north through Mexico in the largest caravan in more than a year. It comes as the U.S. Secretaries of State and Homeland Security are in Mexico meeting with the Mexican president. The leaders looking for solutions to what the State Department calls unprecedented irregular migration in the Western Hemisphere.
What Secretaries Blinken and Mayorkas are going to be pushing for is enforcement, enforcement, enforcement.
As lawmakers on Capitol Hill struggle to make a deal on tightening immigration policy and boosting border security, the Biden administration is hoping Mexico can do more to beef up its southern border. The migrants in that new caravan are starting from southern Mexico after making the trip from Central America, Venezuela, Cuba, and other countries, fleeing harsh conditions and seeking asylum in the U.S. Congressional Republicans are pushing for restrictions on asylum claims as Customs and Border Protection has been overwhelmed with a surge in migrants. Crossings are down from record highs last week when more than 12,000 migrants a day were crossing the border illegally.
We're being overrun. President Biden has abandoned the Border Patrol.
A potent political problem for President Biden heading into a re-election year and a humanitarian crisis for thousands at the border. In Washington, Alice Barr, NBC News.
The visit to Mexico from top Biden administration officials comes after President Biden spoke with the president of Mexico, the two leaders agreeing more needs to be done to curb border crossings. President Biden has also said he's open to significant compromise on border policy and those ongoing negotiations on Capitol Hill. Happening next month in Lewis, updates from the Historical Preservation Architectural Review Commission. According to the commission's agenda, there'll be an update on replacing damaged historic district signs. There will also be an update on the endangered building list. That meeting is slated for Thursday, January 4th at 6 p.m. As we take a live look right now into West Ocean City, a beautiful night so far. Let's check in with our First Alert Chief Meteorologist Paul Williams on our First Alert forecast. Good evening, Paul.
Good evening. You know what? I'm just going to go ahead and say this publicly. I was wrong about the weather yesterday. That's okay, because nobody's perfect. I said it would be raining all day long. You know what? It didn't. So sue me. Listen, I'm just trying to tell you, it turned out to be a better day than even I expected, but we knew we were trending in the right direction. Now, we're still cloudy, we're still gloomy, not a whole lot of sunshine, but we had just enough of a smidgen for us to enjoy some things. Now, this warm front, it's going to continue to push its way more so towards from coming out of the southeast, and that's going to bring in some additional moisture and just enough heat or moisture to kind of push things above the norm for this time of the year with that warm front. Now, we have a tremendous amount of rain. It's actually to our west. And then as you pull this over a little bit more, so you can see that streaming that's happening right now as we're tracking that more so towards the northeast, generally speaking. Now, the average high is about 47 degrees, okay? But we're going to be well above that. As far as the amount of rain, look at this. Just a piddly little, maybe less than a quarter of an inch of rain for us in Salisbury as well as Ocean City. So yet another reason why we would not call for a First Alert Day for today. Now, we are looking forward to stay mostly cloudy, but look at these numbers. I mean, we're talking 57 degrees. That's about 10 above the norm for this time of the year. Now, the question is this. That's going to change by the new year. We'll talk about all that coming up in a moment. Till then, back to you, Maddie.
Thank you. And for more weather updates, pull out your phones right now. Scan this QR code for our First Alert weather app. You can download the app to get all the weather updates you need for free. In health news, a new update on the FDA investigation into illnesses linked to cinnamon applesauce pouches. An FDA official has told Politico the lead contamination seen in these products might have been an intentional act. and those responsible will be held accountable. The FDA found lead levels in cinnamon and over 2,000 times higher than the proposed standards. That was in an inspection conducted in an Austro Foods facility in Ecuador. The cinnamon was supplied by another company, Negasmart. The U.S. Food and Drug Investigation said on Tuesday it has 82 confirmed reports of illnesses linked to high levels of lead in those pouches, some sold at Weiss grocery stores, by the way. The majority of those impacted are very young, but also adults up to the age of 53 have been affected. Coming up, Chesapeake Bay waters, why the Department of Natural Resources in Maryland needs your help as temperatures drop.
And speaking of temperatures dropping, the winds are picking up as well. Ocean City gusty winds. Just how strong will they get? I'll let you know.
First homes across the U.S., the record high prices seen. That's up next.
Welcome to First State Chevrolet, where we put you, the customer, first.
Since 1976, we've been your local hometown Chevrolet dealer. We'd like to thank all of our loyal customers over this past 47 years for their business.
Save over $8,000 on this new 2023 Chevrolet Silverado.
Interest rates as low as 1.9% on the 2024 Chevrolet Equinox.
Merry Christmas! Merry Christmas! Merry Christmas from our family to yours.
Find new roads.
Whoa, we scored?
Yeah, we scored. We're going to the playoffs.
I can't believe I missed that.
Every time I'm buzzed, I spend too much time on my phone.
What? I should take your phone away.
No. I'll call for a ride. Hey, why does my face look like that?
I'm playing with these new face filters.
Okay, you know what?
Yep, that's mine.
I'm going to need that back.
Nope.
Kevin!
Are you dreaming of the perfect shower or bath to elevate your daily routine into a spa-like experience? Baths by Spicer Brothers can make your dream a reality.
With factory-certified, 5-star installation guaranteed. And right now, receive 50% off installation, a free shower door upgrade, and a free deluxe shower head. Plus, enjoy your new shower now and pay later with no interest and no payments for 18 months.
Choose your favorite style and color, and it can be installed in as little as one day. Call today to schedule your free in-home consultation because you deserve the best.
DreamFest is back in Ocean City, Maryland for MLK Weekend. Join us for three soul-stirring shows at the Performing Arts Center January 12th through the 14th. Experience Who's Bad, the ultimate Michael Jackson experience. Marshall Karloff and the Purple Experience. Take Six, 10-time Grammy and Dove Award winners. Secure your tickets at ococean.com/pack. Don't miss Ocean City's second annual DreamFest, January 12th through the 14th. See you there.
This is Coast TV News at 5.
Homes are getting less and less affordable for most Americans. U.S. home prices hit another record high in October, rising for the 9th straight month. That's according to the S&P CoreLogic Case-Shiller U.S. National Home Price Index. The data released Tuesday shows the October prices were up 0.6% from the month before. Compared to a year ago, there was a 4.8% annual change in October from the year prior. That acceleration despite historically low inventory and mortgage rates at the highest levels in 23 years. New tonight in Wicomico County, the sheriff's office has been made aware of a telephone scam. The sheriff's office says the subject on the phone states he's a deputy with the Wicomico County Sheriff's Office and advises that the person answering the phone, they owe money. Now remember, the sheriff's office will never contact people and request money over the phone.
Coming up, Seaford and surrounding areas, subtle showers, more or less than we expected. The answer coming up in a moment.
Ring in the new year with new floors from Carpet and Tile Mart Supercenters.
The selection is incredible.
The salespeople take the time to find what I want.
Right now, save up to 50% mart-wide on carpets, hardwood, waterproof vinyl, laminate, area rugs, and more. All in stock to take home today. Pick, pay, take it away, or have it installed as soon as you save. For free. Hurry in before the sale is over. Only at Airbase Carpet and Tile Mart.
When choosing windows and doors for your home, at Pella, it's your choice. We manufacture maintenance-free vinyl, fiberglass, and wood-clad windows and patio doors, all with lifetime warranties. High performance, energy efficient, and loaded with options to help make your house your home. Industry-first features and benefits make living easier and increase your home's value. Visit our experience center or call us today to schedule your free in-home consultation where we bring the showroom to you.
Get ready for a night of musical magic like never before. Witness the legend, the icon, the one and only Marshall Karloff and the Purple Experience. A Prince tribute band live in concert Saturday, January 13th during Dreamfest weekend at the Roland E. Powell Performing Arts Center. Experience the hit that defined a generation from Purple Rain to When Doves Cry. It's a journey through the soundtrack of your life. Don't miss your chance to see these iconics played live. Grab your tickets, your raspberry beret, and be a part of a night you'll never forget. Head to ococean.com/pack for tickets.
Harrison Senior Living has made it our mission to provide caring and nurturing communities for 50 years. John B. Parsons location accommodates residents on an historic estate in the heart of Salisbury. With a variety of amenities, activities, and services, you can have complete peace of mind knowing that we treat all of our residents like family. Caring for aging loved ones is difficult, but the supportive staff at Harrison Senior Living is there to help. Harrison Senior Living, our family taking care of yours since 1972.
Our biggest sale of the year is back at Blank Volkswagen. It's Paul Hankathon. Our best offers start now on every new vehicle in stock, including Jetta, Arteon, and ID4. Take advantage of Volkswagen's sign, then drive leases on a new 2024 Tiguan. Get low 72-month financing on new Atlas, Tiguan, or Taos. Then get through the holidays by making no car payments for 90 days. Incredible year-end savings are here. It's all happening now during Paul Hankathon at Bohanka Volkswagen of Salisbury.
Well, before we get started, I want to remind you, be sure you take out your phone, open it up, put it on camera, and scan the QR code that's right here in the corner, because it's going to be very important that you keep track of it as we go into the new year. It's a gift free from us. Very handy, and it travels well. Let's take a look at some of the numbers from earlier today. Listen, the tail of the tape, we had less than a quarter of an inch, and we're still tabulating because we're expecting another wave of rain for later tonight. But you can see less than a quarter of an inch in all of our locations, but we had rain nonetheless. And you know what? It was like cuts by a thousand, it's like death by a thousand cuts with the rain because it was just so little. I mean, take a look at where you are right now. You can see it just dancing in the air right now with a lot of the low clouds. Now, we had fog from yesterday, and then when it started raining a little bit more, it kind of pulled out of the way. Well, even though we have some low clouds in place at this present time, we will have temperatures falling into the 50s, and it's going to be pretty dry for us till we get to, pretty dry for us now, because we're looking at that rain that's going to hit us Friday. It's now scurrying on out of the way. Look at where the temperatures are, 50s. Now, we're supposed to be in the 40s, but we're way up there into the 50s, and the winds are continuing to move its way from the east to the west, so a bit of backwards rain in that sense. We do see scattered showers over towards Elliott, Cambridge, and those areas. Not quite as numerous for us here in Sussex County, and we do have this small craft advisor that's active, so we're looking for about 25 mile per hour winds to stay a little bit active down towards Ocean City and those areas. This low pressure system is going to continue to develop, and it develops and just kind of curves around our area in general, but it looks like it's losing a whole lot of its steam. The winds are coming out of the east, and then as far as our projections are concerned, we are looking for a 29 mile per hour wind gust for later tonight. Then it backs off. You see how everything just changes direction so dramatically? Well, that's going to be evidence of that cold front that's going to push through, but it's going to keep the wind zonal, so we're not going to see a tremendous drop there. Take a look at our return your items weather. We're looking at temperatures in the 50s for tomorrow, and we're not looking at much in the way of rain or cloud cover is going to stay thick, but we're not concerned about precipitation. You take a look at Wednesday going into Thursday. It pulls out of the way, so we're clear on Thursday. Magnifique. Then we go into, let's say, Thursday night, 55 degrees. Friday, we were concerned about a little bit of rain, but check this out. Voila, we're going to continue to have it stay mainly clear. Now, we may get a smidgen of rain by the time we get to Friday, 7 o'clock, but even when taking that into consideration, this is where we're going to end up for tonight. But after that, we're not looking at much of a bump after that, so that might perhaps be a tenth of an inch of rain, maybe a quarter of an inch of rain at best. As good as it gets. So for tonight, 52 degrees with scattered showers. Tomorrow, thick cloud cover, but the rain comes to an end. Then for Friday, peekaboo sunshine, actually, and 55 degrees. Finally, here's a look at your extended forecast now. With the extended forecast, keep in mind, by the time we get into next week, that's actually the norm for this time of the year.
Paul, thank you. And even with those mild temperatures this week, and as you say, the norm next week, perfect timing because the Maryland Department of Emergency Management has released some tips on generator safety for when the cold temperatures creep up. The department says generators and fuel should always be used outdoors and at least 20 feet away from windows, doors, and attached garages. And keep your generator dry and protected from rain or flooding. The agency also says let generators cool before refueling. Happening right now, the Maryland Department of Natural Resources is looking for your help. The department is asking those who visit the Chesapeake Bay to be vigilant of sea turtles who exhibit signs of cold stunning. That's a condition that causes animals to become debilitated and experience hypothermia-like symptoms due to prolonged exposure to cold temperatures. According to the department, lethargic and unresponsive animals can be a danger to themselves and boaters. If you see a lethargic, floating, or even dead marine mammal in Maryland waters or stranded on shore, maintain a safe distance and call the Maryland Natural Resources Police Hotline. We have more information on this on our website, CoastTVNews.com. Don't forget to tune in to Coast TV News for Sunday Night Football. It's the Green Bay Packers versus the Minnesota Vikings. Coverage starts at 7 p.m. and we have your hyper-local broadcast after the game.
We salute Ed W. Ramsey Jr., a steadfast brother and lifelong hero, both in spirit and service. Ed's time in the Army is a testament to his commitment to others, his ceaseless dedication to helping those in need, and his boundless heart, filled with love for all, mark him as a truly inspirational figure.
Spicer Brothers and Coast TV are honoring military persons and first responders serving Delmarva. If you have a family member, friend, or community member that you would like to nominate for a Coast TV salute, go to CoastTVSalutes.com.
You know, Brian, the best thing about living in Maryland and Delaware is that we can use our deck year-round.
And Nikki, Paul Davis still has time to install 10 more decks before Christmas.
Sign me up. Paul Davis's AZEK decks are the best. They don't fade or crack, even in the winter.
Our customers love our decks, and our crews are ready to install your deck so you can enjoy the holidays. Call now for your free estimate, and we'll include a fire pit free with your new deck.
Now that is a good holiday.
Paul Davis Restoration and Home Remodeling. We are the difference makers.
Weather is brought to you by Paul Davis Restoration and Home Remodeling, the difference makers.
In Sussex County, Beach Mobile Home and RV Supply has the parts you need.
Powered by over 30,000 square feet of inventory at brass sales and an amazingly knowledgeable staff, we offer plumbing, electrical, windows, doors, tubs, showers, and even roofing and skirting for your manufactured home. Plus an extensive selection of parts and supplies for your RV, no matter the class, size, or style. Beach Mobile Home and RV Supply in Long Neck, Delaware. Your home improvement superstore for all your manufactured housing and RV needs.
Hi, welcome to Toyotathon.
Thanks. Now that the holidays are over, I'm getting a Camry.
and we're getting a RAV4 hybrid.
And I'm getting a Tundra.
Oh, and you're getting a belly rub.
And I'm getting a truck.
Buy a Highlander with Toyotathon special 2.99% APR financing. Or pick a 24 RAV and get special $1,000 Toyota down payment cash.
Come in today, but you're already here.
Toyota, let's go places.
100.9% classic country plays real country.
The closer you get, the further I fall.
6 days on the road and I'm gonna make it home tonight.
Tune to 100.9% classic country or download the app to listen anywhere.
This year, share all the love you have during the 2023 Subaru Share the Love event going on now through January 2nd. With every Subaru purchased or leased, Subaru will donate $250 to one of these five charities and an additional $50 when you choose your hometown charity, plus $5 for every routine service performed. Make the most of the 2023 Subaru Share the Love event and start changing lives in your community together with Gateway Subaru. Love, it's what makes a Subaru a Gateway Subaru. Higher standards.
Sponsored by Ancient Art Stone, where countertops are always a work of art.
In regional news, the Homelessness Alliance for the Lower Shore will be holding a town hall next month. The topic will be addressing homelessness as a community. Participants will be invited to talk openly, share their opinions. That town hall will be held at the Title Health Avery Hall Education Center, that's in Salisbury, on January 15th from noon to 2. And happening right now in Salisbury, ongoing maintenance issues with trash trucks are causing delays in collection routes. The city says the Department of Field Operations are currently experiencing, quote, unprecedented challenges with collection. That's due to issues with the truck's trash pickup for all city routes, and it's going to be staggered now. The city says if your trash is not collected at the usual date and time, you can leave it out for trash crews to collect when they can. However, homeowners are encouraged to reach out to the city if their trash has not been picked up in a timely manner. Well, Christmas may be over, but we love decorating for the holidays and seeing your home. We do this through New Year's. Take a look at your screen. We have a beautiful home from Estella in Ocean Pines. I love that white tree. Thank you, Estella. You can send your pictures and videos, if you want, to coasttvnews.com/holidayhouse. Coming up, a look at this year's Times Square New Year's Eve ball. What's special about it? Next on Coast TV News at 5.
Delmarva's Holiday House is brought to you by Bay to Beach Builders.
Dreamfest is back in Ocean City, Maryland for MLK Weekend. Join us for three soul-stirring shows at the Performing Arts Center January 12th through the 14th. Experience Who's Bad, the ultimate Michael Jackson experience. Marshall Karloff and the Purple Experience. Take Six, 10-time Grammy and Dove Award winners. Secure your tickets at ococean.com/pack. Don't miss Ocean City's second annual Dream Fest, January 12th through the 14th. See you there.
We were thinking about doing this garage to get the dust and everything off the floor. We decided to call a Pinnacle Concrete Coating. He gave us a color option. There must have been 12 or 14 different colors to choose from. Everything they said they were going to do, they did perfect. And they worked, man, I tell you what, those guys worked so doggone. They said they could do it 8 hours, and they did it in 8 hours. This is not a garage no more. It's a room for my vehicle. That's what I love about it. Call up Pinnacle, and I guarantee you'll be happy.
Watch every Governor's Challenge game live this week, exclusively on the Delmarva Sports Network and the DSN app. All the high school hoops on every court, from tip-off to final buzzer to the nightly wrap-up show. Download the DSN app today.
Imagine a knife taking this much abuse and didn't need sharpening. Introducing the incredible NutriBlade knives. They're coated with granite stone nonstick and made of stainless steel, one of the hardest substances on earth. Now everyone can chop, slice, and dice just like a pro. The Easy Grip rubberized handles deliver incredible control and accuracy to chop salads in seconds and cut frozen solid meat with ease and get razor-thin slices every time. The nonstick surface means food slides right off and they're dishwasher safe. Plus, they'll stay razor sharp guaranteed. A complete set of chef knives can cost you hundreds, but today you can get this professional six-piece set of NutriBlades for just $29.95. Order right now and we'll even ship them to you free. Now get your own NutriBlade knives from Granite Stone, the last knives you'll ever buy.
Call 1-800-645-8074 or go to buynutriblade.com.
You suck your teeth into me, blood sucker.
1025 WBOC.
The Times Square New Year's Eve ball will look a little different this year. With only 4 days to go until the ball drops, here's a sneak peek at the new design. This year's ball features a bow tie pattern that will sparkle over Times Square. The new bow tie lighting pattern reflects the shape of the streets below, called the Crossroads of the World. This New Year's Eve, for the first time, the ball will be relit featuring the new bow tie pattern as it rises up the pole to reach its perch above the 2024 numerals.
And it looks like it's going to be good weather for that celebration as well. We still have some small craft advisory active for our neck of the woods, in case you're going to be sticking around a little bit closer to home. But to our north, we actually have a flood watch, so we're going to be mindful of that throughout portions of our, well, the East Coast in general. But here's a look at your Paul Davis Restoration exclusive 10-day forecast. Thursday, cloudy. Friday, peekaboo sunshine. This weekend, we dropped to 48 degrees. But remember, 48 degrees, that's actually the norm for this time of the year. And next week, we're going to stay near the norm as well. But the morning time, it's going to be chilly with temperatures well into the 30s.
Paul, thank you. And thanks for joining us here for Coast TV News at 5. For more news and local weather, download our Coast TV News app. Inside Edition's up next, and we'll see you later tonight for Coast TV News at 6. Have a great night.